Exactly. This is about the least flashy team you could possibly get. They are deeply experienced, they are humble, and they are lifelong public servants. But they are not political. They are just career people.
So let me just put up the list of the women who will be leading the communications team in the Biden White House. But as you point out, it's very notable because Washington is the ultimate old boys club.
It's critical that for the Biden transition team, at least, that they are putting adults in the room. That's why you're seeing a lot of Obama world veterans, both formally and informally. And
Joe Biden breaking a new barrier by announcing an all-female White House communications team.
Joe Biden this morning is moving on with this transition, including trying to make good on this campaign promise to diversify the White House with that first, the all-female communications team.
And he's already pushing ahead on his campaign promise to diversify the White House with a first, an all-female communications team.
Mr. Biden also announced his new White House communications team. It is a diverse, all-female group.
Amazing picture when you look at it all together. Thank you very much, Nicole.
President-elect Joe Biden is set to name another round of key White House and cabinet officials. He's unveiled an all-female senior communications team.
For the first time, all of the senior staffers tasked with shaping White House messaging will be women.
Other thing I'll just say is I was talking to a Democrat who just said this also felt like the Avengers. It felt like we're being rescued from this craziness that we've all lived through from the last 4 years, and now here are the superheroes to come and save us all.
I'm going to show you some more stomach-churning media reaction to Biden's cabinet picks, but first this quick message about the only collagen I trust. Ageless Monte Collagen provides you with the five types of collagen your body needs and one complete protein. As an added bonus, Ageless Monte Collagen is non-GMO, and there's zero artificial flavors, colors, preservatives, sweeteners, gluten, or antibiotics. Get Ageless Multi Collagen for 51% off plus free shipping by going to www.healthwithdronetech.com or by clicking the link in the video description box below. Hey, welcome back, everybody. I gotta tell you, I don't understand how anybody can turn on their TV and watch what's presented as the news and think that they're getting objective truth. I mean, after 4 years of trashing Trump, trashing his cabinet picks, and spinning Russian conspiracy theories that have sown distrust in our institutions, the media is now doing a complete 180 and have become Biden administration cheerleaders. Which isn't at all surprising since they all basically campaigned for him. If Biden becomes president, it's gonna be another repeat of what we saw during the Barack Obama administration, and probably way worse.
But to talk about diplomacy being back, to talk about Joe Biden's empathy and humanity, to talk about diplomacy being back, it is all an implicit rebuke of Donald Trump's foreign policy stewardship over the last 4 years.
Other thing I'll just say is I was talking to a Democrat who just said this also felt like the Avengers. It felt like we're being rescued from this craziness that we've all lived through from the last 4 years, and now here are the superheroes to come and save us all.
This behavior from our former free press should really concern and scare you. Why? Because they're clearly just acting as mouthpieces for the Biden administration, and that's dangerous. During a hypothetical Biden administration, they'll all just smile and nod to whatever Biden says or does. Wallace and Yumanchi, two obvious Democrat Party activists, talk about the, quote, return of diplomacy. When did diplomacy stop? The media just doesn't like the way Trump gets diplomacy done. They think it should be done the way the Washington establishment says it should be done.
With Joe Biden breaking a new barrier by announcing an all-female White House communications team.
Joe Biden this morning is moving on with this transition, including trying to make good on this campaign promise to diversify the White House with that first, the all-female communications team.
And he's already pushing ahead on his campaign promise to diversify the White House with a first, an all-female communications team.
Mr. Biden also announced his new White House communications team. It is a diverse, all-female group.
Oh, so screw diversity, I guess. It's worth noting that while the media applauds Biden, they didn't care that all of Trump's press secretaries have been women. Of course, his communications director and his White House press secretary were men, but I think that would be better since it's more diverse. How can you possibly reflect America when this country is around 50% male, then claim a cabinet of all women is reflective of America? It just goes to show the people who lecture the most about diversity have no consistent standard for it. It basically just means getting rid of white males. Well, that's about all I can stand of these hacks for one day. Keeping up with the lie spewing from the Democrat media is tough, and it requires a lot of time, researching, recording, and editing. So if you want to support this channel, you can do so using one of the links that's listed in the description or in the pinned comment. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.